Hi. In this next release of Azure Automation, one of the key features we're releasing is the ability to create runbooks using a graphical authoring tool. In this little demo today, I'll show you how to create a simple runbook using the graphical authoring workspace. First thing we'll do is we'll create the runbook we're going to work on. This particular runbook we're going to make today is one that will start all of our stopped Azure VMs. Note here we were creating a graphical runbook. We could also create a textual if we wanted to. Now that the runbook has been created, our graphical authoring workspace opens up. Within the workspace on the left, you have your library where you can choose from all of the commandlets, runbooks, global assets, and runbook controls in your system. You also have the canvas where you build your graphical runbook. To create a simple runbook to start all of your stopped VMs in Azure, you require three things. One is you need to authenticate with Azure. Second, we need to get all of the VMs that have stopped. And third, we need to start them. So the first thing we'll do is we'll go over into the assets section here. We'll go down to credentials. And I'll select this Azure credential, which I previously put into our global asset store in Azure Automation. I'm going to rename this to Get. Get Azure credential. And it's already pre-configured to get the credential out of the asset store and pull it into the runbook. The next thing I need to do is I'll need to authenticate with Azure. I'm going to do that using one of the commandlets in the Azure module called add Azure account. And I'll pull it into the canvas. And I will link it up with the get Azure credential activity. Now we're going to configure the add Azure account. I'm going to rename add Azure account to call it connect to Azure. Now I'm going to configure it. And as you add Azure account, one of the properties you need to send in is the credential object. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the object that came from the get Azure credential activity, and I'm going to pass it into this activity. So at this point, we have the authentication part of our runbook done. We get our Azure credential, and then we use it in the connect to Azure commandlet. Next thing we need to do is we're going to need to get all of our virtual machines in our Azure subscription. I'm going to find the get Azure VM commandlet. There it is. Add that to the canvas. And I'll connect it with connect to Azure. Now we don't need to do any special configuration on get Azure VM because it's already set to get all of the VMs in our subscription. Let's change the name of that to a more friendly get VMs. There we go. So finally, we're going to need to start all the VMs that have been stopped. So I'm going to go down and find the start Azure VM. There it is. Add it to the canvas. And we'll link it up to get VMs. So with these two activities right here, the first one is going to get all the VMs in our subscription. The second one is going to start the VMs that have been stopped. Because we don't want to try to start VMs that have already been started, we're going to do some filtering on this link right here. We're going to apply a condition to it. What we're doing in this special expression, which is a PowerShell expression that equates to a true or false. What we're doing is we're getting the output of the activity get VMs, we're getting the power state property on that object, and we're seeing if it's equal to stopped. So only those objects, only those virtual machine objects that have power state stopped will be passed on to be operated on by the start Azure VM commandlet. Let's rename this one to something friendlier. Start VM. So finally, we need to configure the start VM commandlet. And we're going to start the VMs by their VM name. So you see there's three properties for this particular commandlet. There's a name, profile, and service name. Two of them are mandatory and one is optional. So let's set the mandatory parameters, the name. And again, we're going to use the output of the get VMs activity. And because we only need a name here, we're going to get just the instance name of that object. And again, for service name, we're going to do the very same thing. We're going to subscribe to the output of the get VMs activity. And we're going to get the service name property. So at this point, we've created our runbook and configured it. And the next thing to do is to test it out. So here I'm going to start it up. And there you see I've succeeded in starting my two stopped VMs. One of the advantages of graphical authoring and creating graphical workflows is that you can actually see your IT processes visually. In this case, you can see the process very clearly from authenticating to getting the VMs to starting the VMs. So thank you very much. This is a demonstration of our new graphical authoring experience within Azure Automation.